Hi guys. So I'm doing another live because I keep forgetting to say stuff to you guys, and then after I stop it, I'm like, dang it, I should have said this. So I'm gonna do another makeup tutorial using the eyeshadow, the ShadowSense, the foundation, and the LipSense. So before I start though, I'm gonna use, it's called Nangai oil. And I'm gonna use that to just put it on my face before I actually do my eyeshadow. So it has time to dry before I do my foundation. The Nangai oil is just an oil that's supposed to help keep, it's supposed to make your skin like super soft. It's really for dry skin. It has a whole bunch of triglycerides in here. It's supposed to be the purest form of the Nangai net, because Synagen's is the only, they have a, what's it called? They have an agreement with where the country that this comes, or the island that this comes from, and they're only giving the nuts to Synagen's. So that's why we have this, and it's not man-made. Like, it's completely natural. They just cold press the nut and put it in here with a whole bunch of other stuff that's supposed to help with dry skin. So it will last you so long. It makes your skin feel so great and soft. It might be solid when you first get it, and you can just go ahead and roll it between your hands, hold it. It'll add a little bit of heat to it, I guess, to make it less solid. And it comes with this little thing. And you can just go ahead and put two drops into your hands, and that should be enough to completely cover your face. You put it. And if your skin's super dry, it'll work wonders. Like, my sister has eczema, so she's been putting that on her face to try to, or this on her face, to try to help with that, and it seems to be working. Her face is just super dry, so it might take a little while for it to work. So I'm gonna put that on, and then I'm gonna start on my eyeshadow. So the good thing about the ShadowSense is you do not need to put any primer on first. You actually probably shouldn't put any primer on. For most makeups, you want to put the primer on so that it makes it last longer. But ShadowSense will molecularly bond to your eyelids. So you don't want to put anything, no foundation, no primer on before you actually put the ShadowSense on. And today I'm going to show you how you can combine different colors of ShadowSense to make your own colors, which is kind of cool. So I'm going to be using silver violet. It's like a really light purple color, purplish blue, a violet, I guess. And then I'm gonna be using denim. My dog went to town with this because I left it out on accident and he ate it. So it's a little beaten up, but it still works. And then I have a little Java shimmer as well. Thanks for knocking over all my stuff. I had this great system, and then my mom just comes and knocks everything down. Alright, so, yeah, it's just falling, it's okay. But yeah, so I'm gonna use silver violet, denim, which is like a navy blue color, mocha java is the same one I used yesterday, it's like a dark brown, and then candlelight, which is just like a nude, really light color. And a lot of people actually use this for concealer as well. It works really good for concealer as well. Especially since the all of our concealers are out of stock right now. Hopefully they fix the out of stock issue soon. It's because the company grew so fast in such a small amount of time, they haven't had time to catch up with the demand yet. So they're building new machines and everything to make all these products, so it should be fixed soon. And yeah, so I'm only gonna put the ShadowSense on one of my eyes, because I just got TMJ surgery. You can kind of see, like, I'm shaved right here. So basically they went in here and they fixed my jawbone right here. The disc that was right here kind of came displaced, so they had to go in and fix that. So this side of my face is kind of because it's swollen, it's affecting the nerve. Someone just called me. But I can't, yeah, it's numb right now. So I can't move this side of my face that well, so I'm just gonna work with this eye. You don't wanna see me try to work with this one. So I'm gonna mix silver violet and denim together. And remember that ShadowSense a little bit goes a long way. So you can go ahead and just put a little tiny dots on there. And then I'm gonna put denim right over it. And I'll mix it together and it should make a whole different color. And the ShadowSense has blended out really nice. They do, they are a little lighter when you blend them out. If you do wanna add like darkness to it, you can just keep adding. You can add as much of the ShadowSense as you want and it'll get darker. So this is a combination of silver violet and denim. So the silver violet by itself is a really light purple color. And then when I added denim to it, it turned into like a more of a blue color. So it's like a really light blue. And then, yeah, that. And now I'm gonna use Mocha Java Shimmer to, and I'm gonna put it in my crease right here. I promise I am not a makeup professional at all. So if you think I'm doing this wrong, I might be. This is just what I found works with my eyes because they're so small. I don't really have that big of a crease. But ShadowSense blends out really well. I'm using a Mary Kay cream brush to blend it out. It's a cream and concealer brush. I'm just using this because this is what I have. I haven't had a chance to try the Cinegence brushes yet, but we do have some. So after that's all blended out, it kind of got a little higher than I would have liked. But that's okay because I'm using this one. This is Candlelight, and I'm going to just go ahead and put it in my on my brow bone, or right underneath my brow bone, and blend that out. And then you can take like a fluffy brush. This is just the eye color brush from Mary Kay. And I'm just gonna go ahead and blend it all out. Just keep blending, just keep blending. I love how easy it is to blend these, this ShadowSense out. I used the makeup palettes a lot before I got these and I just found like they would blend unevenly between my two eyes. And I'd have to like constantly be fixing it. But these work really well and they blend how I want them to, so it's good. So yeah, that's that. And I'll use mascara now. So since I have like basically zero eyelashes, I go ahead and I curl my eyelashes first, if I can find my eyelash curler. Oh man, it dropped you. I'm sorry. Alright, I can't find my eyelash curler, so we're not going to curl my eyelashes today. They might seem very non-existent. I'm going to use the Mary Kay Lash Primer first, and just put that on my eyelashes. And then I'm going to use the Mary Kay Lash Love Lengthening Mascara. I have not yet used the Cinegence one, because again, the out-of-stock issue has made it very hard to get to order some things. Because they sell it so fast. I got like a whole drop of it right there. And then take my mascara. And just use up and down motions to get the top and bottom of your lashes. This might work better if you have longer ones. And then I do my bottom. I would normally put like a little bit of eyeshadow under here and do eyeliner, but since I don't want it to look too much different than this eye, because I can't really do much with it, I'm just gonna leave it like this. And my face is super soft and the Nangai oil should have sunken in already. So I'm gonna use my foundation. So, sorry, I forgot something. So this ShadowSense does not smear. It's just like the LipSense. So after you blend it all together, you can go ahead and like rub it, do whatever you want. I know since I don't normally, before I got these, I wasn't used to wearing makeup like all the time. So I'd rub my eye and I'd be like, dang it, like now it's all over my finger and like smeared all over the place. This will not smear. Like there's nothing on my finger after I do that. So it works really well. And so now I'm gonna use foundation. So I'm using the color almond in the anti-aging formula. We have the normal formula and the anti-aging. They will both adapt to up to 3 colors to match your skin tone. So don't worry about it not, because you can't really try it before you order it since it's all online. You can order little testers. Go ahead and message me if you'd like to, and I can order little testers for you. But I wouldn't worry about it that much. Just like try to match your skin color to the little, to the color swatches they have online. If it is not within the 3 shades and it doesn't perfectly match you, don't worry, everything's 100% satisfaction guaranteed. You can go ahead and send it back to me, and you can either get your money back or I can get another color for you. Whatever you prefer. So I'm gonna go ahead, this one's almond again. When you get the anti-aging, you might wanna go a shade lighter. That's just, I know I said darker last time, I messed up. It's lighter, you wanna go a shade lighter for anti-aging. It's different than, just cause it's a different formula than the normal one. So that's what they recommend. But I'm just gonna go ahead and dab this all over my face because I'm gonna use a beauty blender to blend it out. And have it all over my hand. So. And then I'm gonna use my beauty blender and just blend it out. You do not, also do not need to put primer on for the foundation because again, it won't bond to your skin. And like all the other foundations I've tried, you've had to put some type of like moisturizer or something on before because it just didn't blend out as well. But this blends out really well and just completely covers my face. And it will, just like the ShadowSense and the LipSense, it's waterproof, smearproof. So especially since like I know I have really red cheeks, like my foundation would, I would really notice when my foundation wore off. But this one I've had no problems with. So you go ahead and put that on. And another good thing about this is since it's smear proof, when you are talking on the phone or something, it will not transfer to your phone because I've had that problem too. Now we have the brush collection. Oh wait, I'm gonna go back to the shadow real quick, or the foundation. So this also comes in a collection. With this, you get the foundation, the Foops remover, which will remove the face and eyeshadow, and then you get a pearlizer. The pearlizers, you can either use it to put like a dewy finish over your foundation, or you can use it as kind of a highlighter and just like pick where you wanna put it. My pearlizer has been backordered, so I don't have it yet. But once I get that, I'll definitely show you how it works. So yeah, and then let's move on to the brush, or the translucent powder collection. So this collection, it has the bronzer, which is bronze dust. I don't know if you can see that, there you go. And then the blush, silver rose, and the just regular translucent powder, which is natural, which I do not know where my mom put that. My natural one. You're gonna give me 2. While she finds that, I'm gonna show you how to use these. So the bronze dust one is like a bronzer. So you'll go ahead and just tap it and it'll come out. And you wanna put it like on your cheek or on whatever this thing is. And you don't need a lot because it just blends out really nicely. The blush as well, you just go ahead and tap it, make sure it's coming out, and then put it above the bronzer. just to add a little bit of color. And the here's the natural powder. My mom finally found it. This one you'll just go ahead and put all over your face to seal in your foundation. This is the only one I tap multiple times because I am putting it all over my face. And if you'd like to put more of the bronzer and blush on, you can. I just choose not to because, I just like more of a natural contour, but it's up to you, your personal preference. So yeah, that's my face. Now I'm gonna move on to LipSense. So yeah, today I'm gonna show you Bay Champagne. This is what it looks like. I can't even. Bay Champagne, you can't really see it. Kind of, I don't know. It's Bay Champagne. And then Blu-Red. What I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna put Blu-Red on my bottom and then Bay Champagne on the top so you can see that after you put it on and you like rub your lips together, it will not transfer between your lips. So I'll go ahead and start with both of them. And you wanna make sure that you're shaking them a lot. But before you put them on, you want to completely make sure that your lips are clean and dry. So I've heard people use witch hazel, and you can get that on Amazon, or the Garnier Meisler liquid stuff. I just use my Mary Kay makeup remover. This is just the makeup remover I have, and I'm going to go ahead and just wipe off my lips, making sure I get in the waterline as well. And then dry them off. I make sure to get my waterline as well because that's where, since all your saliva sits there, that's where it's gonna come off first. That's where it'll fade first. So, again, you're just gonna go ahead and shake it. And I'm gonna start with Bay Champagne. And you want to do 3 layers on both lips. And you want to make sure you go in one direction. Because if you go like forward and backward, like normal lipsticks, it'll take off some of the color that you already put on there. So I'm going to start with Bay Champagne. And you want to make sure you do really thin layers. I'm not going to be able to talk much during this part. But like my mom pointed out last time, if you see me touching my lips, it's because I'm trying to see if it's dry. They don't take long to dry, you just want to make sure it dries between the layers. So I go ahead and wipe off all the excess, and then I'm going to put it on my top. And then I'm gonna get Blu-Red. Shake that one as well. Get your hand. So then I sealed it in with glossy gloss. And as you can see, there's no transfer between the two colors. So this one's beige champagne, and this one's blue-red. And I can rub it together, and they do not transfer. So if you ever want to do two different colors, you can. I chose to do blue-red and beige champagne, because beige champagne is like the lightest color I have, and then blue-red is the brightest. Just to show you that it does not transfer. When you buy the collection, when you first get your LipSense, you have to buy the collection because you'll need the color, the glossy gloss to seal it in, and then the oops remover to remove it. Here's the oops remover. I'm actually going to show you how to remove it today. Also, we have different glosses. So I have the glossy gloss, the matte gloss, and this bougainvillea gloss. This one is really pretty, and it just kind of adds like extra sparkle and like a pink tint to your color a little bit. I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but it does change the color, like just adds a pink tint to it. I don't know if you'll be able to tell though. You can also wear any of the glosses by themselves. The glossy gloss is really nice because it will hydrate your lips, and this is the one that hydrates them the most. All of them are hydrating glosses, but the glossy gloss is the most hydrating. And if you would like to use the other glosses, you just want to make over the LipSense. You just want to make sure you seal it in with glossy first, and then you can add any color over it. Okay. And now I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to remove it. So you'll use the glossy gloss, or just kidding, you use the oops remover to remove it. You can also use the oops remover to, like, right here, kind of messed up. So if I was going to leave it on, I'd go ahead and put it, like, right outside my lips just to make sure I got off every mess up. That's why it's called oops remover. But you'll go ahead and put a generous amount on it. Okay, I did not do that right. Because you should take the gloss off first. But we're just gonna keep going with it. So just put a generous amount, and I always wipe off this one will get dirty. The glossy gloss one stays white, but this one will get dirty. So I always wipe it off after I put it on because I wanna keep it as clean as possible. Put it on both of my lips. And then you let it sit there for at least a minute. So we'll sit here and wait a little bit. If you do have any questions, you can go ahead and comment, and I will answer them as best as I can. So I'm gonna tell you just a little bit about why I like this lipstick. So I've liked lipstick for a long time, but I've always kind of strayed away from wearing it because it gets all over the place. Like, I've never even seen a lipstick like this that'll stay on and not transfer onto cups, or, because I like to drink a lot of things with straws, so it would transfer onto a straw, it would flake off really easily, like in different spots, and it's gonna be all spotty, and you just have to constantly be worrying about reapplying it. And also, you do not have to worry about it getting on your teeth when you use LipSense, which is really nice because I know, like, when I had to cheer at games and stuff and we have to constantly be smiling, I would always be scared that I had got lipstick on my teeth because we were supposed to wear red lipstick, or at least like a bright color. And I was like, people are gonna see it if it gets on my teeth. So I would be worried about it all the time. But you do not have to worry about it with this. And now I get to wear lipstick all the time because I know it won't transfer, it won't become all spotty and everything, and I don't have to worry about reapplying it unless it gets off of my waterline, and even then, like, it's up to you whether or not you want to reapply it or not. So I'm gonna go ahead, it's been a while, so I'm gonna wipe it off. And I feel like the reds are the most pigmented, so you might have to add a little bit more. Like, Now I'm just gonna add a little bit more and let that sit there. Also, just to let you guys know, if you want, all of these products I've used today, I have in stock. So I have like a, it might not be in stock online, but I do have stock of it. And just go ahead and message or comment if you would like any of them, and I can get them sent to you right away. This month, since it's my first month selling it, I'm giving a 15% off discount on everything. And it, all of the products are already 100% satisfaction guaranteed. If you don't like a color, go ahead and send it back to me. You can get your money back. I can get you another color. It's up to you. I actually haven't gotten a color yet that I haven't liked. They all kind of just work. Like, I feel more confident. Like, I never would wear red lipstick. I feel more confident wearing it now just because it's, like, I like the lipstick and it looks fine. It doesn't look like normal red lipsticks make me look like a clown. I love it. I love this stuff. So that's that. And I'm gonna just go ahead and wipe the rest of this off. Today I actually got lip balms in stock. This stuff went out. You can't see it. This stuff went out of stock within an hour when it came back in stock. People like jump on this. And I'll go ahead and put it on. So it's just really moisturizing. It's not like other lip balms that have wax and other chemicals in them. It's just completely meant to hydrate and repair your lips. It will not dry out your lips like other companies' lip products do, and make you constantly be reapplying them because they just feel as dry or maybe drier than it did when you first applied it. Like, it'll constantly be hydrating your lips. So if you're interested in these, I have them. Again, everything is satisfaction guaranteed, and they will last you so long. I know that they do seem a little pricey, but you're paying for the quality. Like, all the products work really well. They stay on, and don't be scared to buy them because they're 100% satisfaction guaranteed. If you don't like it, we can fix that for you. You can get your money back. You can get another color. Also, if you don't like the color, chances are you can, if you layer it with another color, you'll like that layering combination. Like, you can do so many things with these. Yeah, that's about it. If you have any questions, feel free to comment or message me and I'll answer them right away. And thank you all for watching. Have a great day. Bye.